Hi, continuing your description of the heat equation and how to solve it, we are now going to actually implement the solution of the heat equation by starting out with a particular one and showing, and I'm going to show you all the steps. So our starting point is the following equation. I need to solve, let's see, dT dt equals 3 times d squared t dx squared plus 4 x plus 1, I'm just making something up, x plus 1 times t minus 30. Okay, this is g of t, this is the heat supply. Okay, so this is the differential equation. And like all differential equations, I need a starting condition. Let us put t of 0, that is at time t equals 0. T of x comma 0 is f of x, which is given as let us say 25 degrees. Okay, so this is all in degrees. So what it is that I have a bar. So by the way, the bar is from 0 to 1, uniform length. Okay, and this is my initial condition. I need to be given this. This tells me what's the initial temperature distribution of the bar. Don't ask me how come f of x is a number. It's just a constant, okay? You could have f of x is 25 times x if you like. I mean, depends upon what are the initial conditions are. So I'm saying I got a bar which has initial condition at 25 degrees centigrade. Then I need to get T at 0 equals 25 plus 0.3 times time. This is called g of t. This is boundary condition. Notice that what it means is that this end of the bar is continuously being heated. It starts out at 25 degrees and slowly, as time changes, it gradually goes up. Okay, at T at L is not given. But what we know is dt dx at x equal to L is equal to 4. So this is the heat flux condition. So what do I do? Step one. Discretize the bar. I am going to choose ten points. Why 10? You can choose 100,000, whatever you like. But right now I'm choosing 10. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There you go. So there is the bar. And I have 10. This is I equal to 1. This is I equal to 10. Then, if there were points like this will be the 0th point, and this will be the 11th point if there were points there. You see what I mean? So there are 10 points. So delta x will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Can you see? If I divide it into 10 points, delta x will be 1 over 9. There are 9 gaps. So in general, delta x will be 1 over n minus 1. So remember that. Okay. So I got that. And if I want to find, this is, so I'm going to number the gaps. This is gap number 1, gap number 2, so on. And so when I equal to 1, so xi, the position of the ith node equals I minus 1 times is equal to I minus 1. So for example, sorry, times delta x, 1 over n minus 1. In our particular case, this looks like I minus 1 times 1 over 9. Right? That's the location of the ith location. Right? 10th location will be, of course, 1. So you can compute, so it goes from 0 to 1. Okay, so we got all of this. then our differential equation will become partial ti with respect to t. Sorry, let me write down the discrete version directly. T n plus 1 I equals T n I plus delta T k over x squared, sorry, delta x whole squared T n I plus 1 plus T n I minus 1 minus 2 T n I plus delta T g of so delta t times, let's write this out specifically rather than doing all this. So you can see that it's given by this function. So I'm going to write 4 times xi minus plus 4, sorry, xi plus 1 times tni minus 30. That's what it says, that thing. Right, so this is what I have to solve, but this is true only in the inside. That means I equal to 1 to n, sorry, 2 to n minus 1, that is 2 to 9. What about I equal to 1? At I equal to 1, T and I is given very simple, equal to 25 plus 0.3 ti. That's easy. Tni is given explicitly. Sorry, Tn, not ti. So the nth time step, I find that out. And then finally, for how about the other end? At the other end is a tricky one, so pay attention. So at the end, at I equal to n, we have, if I write down the differential equation, I will get T n plus 1 n equals to, in our case, n is 9, sorry, n is 10, that's equal to 10. I will get T n 10 plus delta T k over delta x squared T n 11 plus T n 9 minus 2 T n 10 plus delta t plus 4 delta t times 1 plus 4 t n 10 minus 30. Everything is nice other than t n. This is the only one that's in trouble, but we don't have a problem because we use boundary condition and get partial t with respect to x at x equal to 1 is equal to, is approximately t n 11 minus t n 9 over 2 delta x, which must be equal to 4. So t n 11 equal to 4 times 2 times 1 over 9 plus t n 9. So just take